Hey people, this is Amani. Welcome to my podcast Chat2Amani, hashtag brainbabble, a little offshoot from our app Fight for Amani Instagram page. I hope to document and share the highs and the lows and everything in between of my life since being diagnosed with incurable brain cancer. So today's episode is actually a bit different because it's kind of a combination of a vlog and a podcast. Let's call it plog. Does that even make sense? Basically, a podcast and a vlog had a baby and it's now a plog. So what today's episode is about is actually very different because it's about a campaign that I've been involved in with Brain Tumour Research. We went to film an advert actually for a new campaign called Stop the Devastation of Brain Tumours.
Hello everybody! I don't know why I'm putting on an accent. It's probably because I think I'm an American film star today. We are off on a little road trip to
a secret location.
To do some filming for a brain tumour research advert. And that's all we're going to say.
More later.
Bye. If I can make a better way, so you can see a better day, baby, I would. Baby, I would. So, miraculously, we've arrived at the location, considering Mum's questionable driving.
Great driving.
But we're here, so I mean, next update will be after it's finished, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
We arrived at the set and it was a derelict kind of house, old building. It was quite poignant actually, and you know, we rang the bell or knocked on the door and no one answered, and the door was kind of open, so we just walked in. Thank goodness it wasn't someone's actual house, because we could have ended up getting arrested, which probably would not have helped the campaign. So we walked through the house. It was very old and rickety. It was a bit of an obstacle course kind of to get up, but I did manage. And so we walked in and we met a few lovely, lovely people from the charity. A lady called Susan, and then people behind the production team as well. A lady called Fee, and they kind of sat down and spoke me through what is exactly to be expected throughout the day. So, you know, there was set hard-hitting facts about brain tumours and the lack of funding and, you know, the points that they really wanted to highlight. And everyone was going to be recorded. Everyone involved was going to be recorded saying those lines. And then obviously they would edit it together however they saw fit and how they felt it would make the most impact. So they even had this kind of room with like a makeup table and lights, and you know, it was just such a strange experience. It's just something that you just never think that you're going to have to be involved in or that you really want to be involved in, but I am in this situation, and it was a challenge. I was very nervous and anxious. It's something that I've not done before, but it was also exciting at the same time because I did see it as kind of a challenge, and also I want to be part of making a change. And you know, I did, from just sitting down with them for those few minutes before we started, you could tell how passionate and how invested all these people are and how much they care, because they took all that time to sit there and reassure me and explain things through with me, so I understood exactly what was to come and nothing was like a surprise. So we went up to the floor where they decided that my part would be filmed on, and they had the statistics printed out in kind of bold letters, introduced me to, you know, the camera crew. You know, they really acknowledged and took the time to reassure me that they understand it is a big deal for me. I've not been on camera before, and that has been a big part of my struggle in coming to terms with the illness has obviously been coming to terms with the physical changes as well as the mental struggles behind that. But I knew that trying to push myself to do something like this, and if I did enjoy it, and the fact that I was pushing myself out of my comfort zone for the greater good, you know, it did give me that push to try and take this step, and then I would feel accomplished afterwards and better about it. And then maybe I'd even be able to get involved in different campaigns, because that anxiety and that worry and that fear behind the physical changes due to my illness and medication, I would have overcome that barrier. So we started the filming with the set lines. You know, they gave me all the instructions, look directly at this camera, and I have double vision, so it was a bit tricky for me at times. I wasn't sure which one was the actual camera and which one was the, you know, the double vision, but you adjust quite quickly, you can figure it out. And, you know, I did muck up a few times. They didn't rush me, they didn't put pressure on me, you know, they gave me all the time in the world. They were so understanding, all the film crew as well. They let me watch back the bits that they'd filmed just so I could kind of see what angle they were coming in from and how they were doing it. And I did actually at one point get quite upset at watching myself back, because even though it has been, you know, the change wasn't overnight and it has been gradual, sometimes I do still see pictures of myself and barely recognize myself, and that does upset me. And then it's one thing it being in the privacy of your own home, but then it's another thing altogether to know that this potentially could be used over social media. And, you know, it's something that everyone struggles with, not just if you're unwell, you know, a picture that you don't particularly like, you don't really want it to go everywhere, you only want to show your best side. And then Fee actually, you know, she told all the crew to stop. She came and sat down with me on the sofa and, you know, she just reassured me that it's okay. No one notices these things more than you. This campaign ad is about so much more, and the focus isn't about appearance. It's not like, you know, this is not what Fee said, but this part, you know, it's not a Vogue billboard, you know, it's not a Vogue magazine. The point is the rawness. Fee explained how she had lost a really dear friend of hers to a brain tumour, and that is what has made her so passionate and has made her want to be so involved in campaigning for a change. And I remember I was sat with her on the sofa and I just said to her, I'm so sorry about your friend. And she just turned around back at me and she said, I'm so sorry about what's happening to you. And we both got a bit emotional, and that moment there just kind of reaffirmed why I'm doing it. And yes, you know, I'm not at my most comfortable and I'm not at my most confident, but it's okay, because hopefully this is going to help people. Hopefully it's going to help me, and, you know, it's going to be something that I can be proud of. I've heard the facts about the underfunding. I've heard the facts about, you know, prognosis and survival rates so many times. But I think one statistic this time, when, you know, I had to repeat it quite a few times, really did actually stick with me, and it did affect me. And that's someone that's heard it so many times. And it was the fact that 88% of people die within 5 years from their diagnosis. And just especially for someone young, 5 years is nothing. You know, I think back to how fast high school went. That's 5 years. That was a blink of an eye. It's just, it's terrifying and it's scary and it's not good enough. And that did play on my mind. And I think about, you know, the power and hopefully the impact that it can have on people hearing it for the first time. And that will help push people and make them feel like this is unfair, this isn't right, and this has to change. And, you know, the lack of funding, the fact that only 1% goes to brain tumours, even though it is the biggest killer of children and adults under 40 out of all cancers, there should be more outrage, there should be more anger, and there needs to be a change. So all in all, the experience in itself, it was a challenge for me, but it was also a really fun experience. It was such a nice thing to be involved in. It was nice to meet other families, other fighters, and to be a part of something that hopefully will make a difference and help other people. And it helps to give me purpose. It's something that I can say that I've done and I've overcome, and kind of that feeling of like, okay, well, what can I do next? What's stopping me now? Just helping me to take these steps and to regain some confidence. And then if I'm helping other people, then I can't really ask for a better combination. It was enjoyable, but that doesn't mean it wasn't difficult and it wasn't a challenge for me. It was. Even waiting to see the final cut of the advert and seeing some of the pictures, because they did take a lot of still shots as well. They did a bit of kind of a photo shoot that they might use in other campaigns or other, you know, press releases later. It was nerve-wracking. My anxiety was high and I did get a bit upset, but I carried on going, and I think maybe that is something that I should be proud of. And then watching the 30-second ad when it came out, the fact that, you know, it might reach a lot of people, it is scary. And when I looked at it, I didn't think, oh my gosh, I look so great. I mean, I'm only in it for a few seconds, if that, but the ad in itself is very powerful, and I'm honored that I was even a part of it. And yeah, let's make a change.
So it is about 4:30 and we just finished filming on set. It's a wrap, as they say.
So yeah, I mean, all in all, like, it was definitely worth the travel and worth a little bit of a stress at getting ready in the morning. Hopefully it will, like, make a difference and really touch people, and it was just a really good experience.
Now let's start praying that we make it home in one piece with mum's driving in London.
Yeah, no, but you should be really proud of yourself, Amani. This is a really important thing to get involved in. Hoping to get the message out there and increase the funding through the Brain Tumour Research. And
let's make a change.
They want people to take a photo with their hands in front of their face with the hashtag no more. The idea is not only the hand in front of the face saying stop the devastation, but also because then you can't really see who's exactly behind the hand. And that's poignant because brain tumours are so indiscriminate. It doesn't matter how old you are, doesn't matter where you're from, what religion you are, they are indiscriminate and they can affect anyone at any time and destroy lives. So they want, the Brain Tumour Research want you to donate £5, tell 5 people and share. And hopefully this can be the start of change, and maybe it can help a lot of families, and I hope it can. And like I said, I'm so glad that I was a part of it. You know, maybe this can finally be the start of creating the outrage that is needed to make people want to stand up and fight for us. Because at the moment, we are just being ignored, and too many lives are being lost, and too many families are being destroyed. And like the campaign says, it's time to stop the devastation.
Brain tumours kill more children and adults under the age of 40 than any other cancer.
Like my daddy.
Just 1% of the national spend on cancer research is spent on brain tumours.
Donate to Brain Tumour Research to stop the devastation.
Did you know that some brain tumours, like mine, are inoperable?
And this isn't just a select few affected.
Every 2 hours, someone in England is diagnosed with a brain tumour. Please donate to Brain Tumour Research to stop the devastation.
Our daddy gave us the best hugs.
Mine shaped me, but it won't change me.
I'm fighting this tumour for my family.
88% of people diagnosed die within 5 years.
Brain tumours kill more children and adults under the age of 40 than any other cancer.
But just 1% of the national spend on cancer research has been for brain tumour research.
That's unacceptable.
Please donate to Brain Tumour Research today to stop the devastation.
I lost my son, Shay.
I lost my husband and they lost their dad.
I lost my best friend.
For all of them, and for those still fighting, please donate to Brain Tumour Research today to stop the devastation.
I hope everyone finds the ad powerful and gets involved with the campaign, and that it can reach as many, many people as possible. And hopefully our voices will be heard. Thank you for listening.
Everyone has their fight, so let's ready our armies and let the battle commence, because we're not going down without a fight. Like, comment, share and subscribe. I've always wanted to say that.